that makes me feel like a warrior, you know, really, like,
crazy.
I'm not that tough.
Right?
I'm a big whiner.
Yeah, but not at that moment.
But not at that moment. I was like, boom, I had it.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Santa Clarita Birth Center Birth Story. We have our lovely friend, Sandy, Sandra. I don't know what you prefer to go by. I always call you Sandy.
Either.
Sandy or Sandra. She's also a wonderful photographer, and we've known each other for many years. Mm-hmm. And she's going to share her birth story that we did this little one together. But we met many years prior at a birth. Back when I remember the day of the birth was my son was graduating elementary school.
Oh, great.
And it was his day of graduation. I remember being at this birth needing to
I
don't
want to
miss his graduation. The life of a midwife is, we miss birthdays, holidays, big events. And I remember it was a really big deal. It was my oldest and he was graduating. And I thought, oh my gosh, I'm going to miss this. But I was able to get there just in time, in my birth clothes. I was able to roll into the elementary school, and I made the graduation ceremony.
Good.
So Sandy's going to tell us about her birth story.
Okay, so, yeah. I actually have two children. I have a 11-year-old daughter, Clara, and she was born in hospital. And then this one was born here at the birth center, Audrey, and she's one.
Audrey.
I'll start with my first birth experience because that was, you know, I don't know, significant. Well, I'm actually from a family of midwives, basically. Okay. My aunt and my cousin run a birth center in Nipissing, Ontario. And I used to actually, I don't know if you know this or not, but when I was like 12 years old, I wanted to be a midwife because my aunt was learning and everything. But then it got too real for me.
Yeah.
I'm too, you know, by the time I was like 18, I was like, no.
Not doing that.
I can't be in charge of other people's lives. So, not in charge, but, you know.
Be responsible. It's a big responsibility.
Yeah. So anyway, that's why I went into birth photography. But I get to be there, but I don't have to be responsible for anything.
That's what I'm going to be when I'm done kids' meetings.
Right?
I'm going to be a birth photographer.
Birth photographer. I'll teach you.
It's a great profession.
Yeah. So, I wanted, I believe in midwifery care very much. But my first baby, I had Kaiser in Lancaster and I was broke and there was just no way. There was no way it was happening. So I had her, and even as a hospital birth, it was so much worse than I was expecting. Because, like in Canada, there's more. I'm from Canada.
Yeah.
In Canada, there's more support for the mothers.
Mm-hmm.
Like there, my sister was in a birth tub for her labor in the hospital.
Yeah.
And so there was none of that. Obviously, you know. And I was basically hooked up to machines, laying on my side, and...
Were you induced, or did you go into labor
spontaneously? I had nothing. I was completely healthy, no induction, no nothing. Baby was fine, but I was still hooked up to, like, a million things. And the nurses would come in and basically be like, you know, you should get an epidural. There's no point in this. You're causing yourself needless pain and all this stuff. They're very discouraging. No helpful, you know, positions or anything like that.
Yeah.
So
we talked interrupt for 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
We talked a little bit about this at a, we did a Midwives Monday thing about the patient load is so great in a hospital environment with a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
It's so hard because I'd like to believe that the nurses really do want to give good care. They
right.
really would like
yeah.
to be there and help you manage.
But they're stretched so thin.
They're just so stretched
right.
so thin.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, it's so much easier when moms are managed with epidurals. They're quiet. They can manage
right.
the pace.
Exactly.
It makes everybody around you feel better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, and unfortunately, I did get a a bad egg. I'm actually from the other part of my family is all nurses, so yeah. High respect for nurses.
Yeah.
But I got a bad seed. I did. Mm-hmm. So she was not nice to me, and she wasn't. She was nasty. Nice. So anyway, I got through it. It was
fine.
Did
you get an epidural?
I did get an epidural, mm-hmm. like right before I pushed her out, basically. Mm-hmm. I don't really particularly have any regrets about my first, but about everything other than the fact that I would have loved to be with a midwife.
Yeah.
But anyway, so years later, okay. I'm doing birth photography, and I'm at this birth, and it was actually that first birth that I was just like, oh God, I want this so bad. Yeah. Like, being there, you know, I knew all of this stuff.
We drove together.
But being there, did we?
I drove
we did.
You home.
No, you
I
drove,
picked you
yeah,
up,
Yeah, you definitely
too.
Drove me.
No, maybe not.
Maybe for one, okay. One of them.
Yeah, I drove you home. I remember driving you home.
But yeah, I think you did drive me home. And here you were trying to get to your...
I was.
And you still drove me
I drove you home.
Well, it would have been right on the way.
Yeah.
So anyway,
You did it.
It was so much more real that I was just like, I need this for my next. I can't mm-hmm. do that again the yeah. way it was with my first. So, she's got stickers on her.
You too.
So I actually, the time span in between my children is largely due to that. My first was 10 when she was born. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the reason for that is because I was like, I'm not getting pregnant again until I can have a midwife birth. Mm-hmm. So we waited. And then it took a little longer too to actually get pregnant once we were ready. So, but yeah, that's part of the reason why there's so much time in between, because I was like, I'm not doing that again. Yeah. I'd rather not have another baby than do the first time again. So, here we are. And it was so, in the end, it was everything that I hoped it would be. I know that doesn't work out for everybody. But
you also have such a unique temperament.
Yeah.
Just joyful all the time.
Right.
You went into the birth with such joy. You really did. Mm-hmm. It was like incredible joy and excitement and gratitude.
Mm-hmm.
You were just so full of joy.
I've been looking forward to that moment like that for so many years that I was just happy to be there.
And it was really remarkable the whole time. I mean, you were just, there was a picture of you just smiling moments before she was born. And there was no point in the labor. I mean, it wasn't very long, but there was no point in the labor where you got to that place of, I want it to be over. When is it going to be over? Pull her out.
No.
Help me get through this. You were just joyful.
Mm-hmm.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It might have been going on in my head a little
bit. Maybe. Yeah.
But it's also very hard to not be joking around all the time when you're married to the man that I'm married to.
Yeah. He's also very joyful. Yeah. These
and luckily
legs
it doesn't,
are so perfect.
It doesn't,
I just have to say.
It doesn't piss me off when he jokes.
Yeah.
To make
me. And he was appropriately joking.
Yeah.
It was beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. It was good. So anyway, that's kind of my thing.
So your birth with her, they had so much anticipation. Really, you really wanted it to be a certain way.
Right.
And it was. It seems like it turned out the way that you wanted it
mm-hmm.
to.
It almost didn't, because she was breech.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
For a little while.
Yeah.
And then you went head down?
Yeah.
Yeah. You were head down when you came out. Yep.
Which, that was actually an important thing, because I kind of made peace when that happened.
Oh,
it broke
right.
that whole thing in my head where I had to have it a certain way.
But we didn't have to do an external version. She turned
on
her own.
No, she did turn on her own, but I used chiropractic.
Yeah.
She turned it like, it was late.
It was
like 38 weeks.
Yeah. That's a really good point. The baby turned at 38 weeks. I mean, it happens. Second babies especially. But I do remember that now. I remember we were actually doing a prenatal in one of the bedrooms, and I remember being like, I can't believe this baby's breech. No, but I remember being like, I can't believe after all of this time that this is going to end up in a breech. Like, this is crazy.
Yeah.
And then she turned.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah.
So I kind of made peace with that. That was actually important to me to work through all that stuff and relax at the birth, actually, because if that hadn't happened, I would have been totally crushed if something went wrong and I had to go to the hospital. But I was relaxed because I was like, whatever happens, I'm good, you know?
Yeah, and that is a really key issue when you're having a baby. It's like, you know what, you best laid plans, you create the team, you do your prenatal care, you do all the things you can do, and then you let go.
Right.
And be okay with however this journey ends.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Right.
Really, really a critical point in when we're having our babies is we can't control the universe. You can't control everything. So what you can do is you do the best you can in your pregnancy. You eat everything in moderation. You do everything in moderation, making sure that you're healthy. You're not abusing alcohol. You're not abusing drugs. You're not abusing pharmaceuticals. You're living in moderation. And then knowing that the birth is going to take the course it needs to take, as long as everything is, you're being monitored, everything is safe.
Yeah.
But letting go of that need.
Well, and it's important to be a certain way. To not have anxiety about that, because I do get anxiety. So for me to take that step to just be like, okay, it's fine. No matter what, it's going to be fine. Because I knew I was in good hands. Yeah. If there was something wrong,
we would know.
We'd go in. And you would take me in.
I think it's a recurring theme in the birth stories that we have is I think the lesson is always let go once you start labor. Let go. Mm-hmm. It's okay. It may not end up in your dream birth. You might wind up being transported to the hospital. You might wind up with a C-section. There are those things that can happen, but going into the event saying, I'm ready for the ride.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So yeah, it was really good. And I was lucky that, you know, in the end I got exactly what I wanted.
So you arrived and
let's just talk for a minute before I arrived.
Yeah.
Renee.
Let's reminisce about that story. I probably said something like, you're not in labor. Did I say something like that?
No. Okay. This is...
I'm famous for like, oh, it's too early. Oh, I'm sure nothing's going on.
No, because...
Oh, you're pushing?
That's good. No. Everything was clockwork there. I went into labor early that morning, like in the morning at like 8 o'clock, which is strange, right?
Mm-hmm. Just start that time,
yeah. So really early in the morning, and we just basically did errands and stuff, but I walked here because I live across the street. I walked here in labor, in very significant labor.
Yeah.
I remember being on one side of Lyons Avenue, pressing the button to, like, you know,
cross
the street.
Yeah.
And just praying that I didn't have a contraction when I was crossing the street.
And that light is so long.
Because I walk
here, and I'm always stuck at the light, and I'm like, oh, I'm stuck in traffic.
I know.
I'm stuck at the light.
And it's a really wide street, too. So I was like, and my contractions were coming, like, pretty
so
good,
funny.
You know? And I ended up having a contraction on one side of the street. I crossed, like, I was like, I crossed, and I had another contraction right on the other side of the street.
Yeah.
But I made it. Like, the timing.
So funny.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Crazy. And you came in, and we were set and ready, and you were, did we even do an exam? Did we even check to see how dilated you were? I don't even recall.
I don't remember.
Oftentimes,
maybe you did.
We might have. We often won't do a vaginal exam.
But I think only once.
Yeah. If we do one, usually it's once. Especially with a mom that's already had a baby, we often don't really do vaginal exams because there's such normal. There's behavior that's indicating what's going on.
Maybe you checked
but
me
you
because
were so,
I was
yes. Couldn't tell because you were just like this.
Well, and I was like, you were like, do you want to get in the tub? And I'm like, I'm like, hell no.
Oh, no.
I'm going to get this baby out.
Oh, wait. But didn't you get it? You're like, will it slow everything down? I was like, no, it won't slow everything down. You're like, okay. So we got the tub ready. And then you were like, no, 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 I'm not doing that. I'm in a walk because I'm not doing this all night. And then you had your Wonder Woman shirt on and you're like, just like joyfully saying, I'm going to keep walking and get this baby out.
Right.
And you did because you just got into the tub and then started pushing.
Yeah. Yeah. I it didn't feel like that quite, but I know from being there, it is like that, but when you're doing it, it doesn't feel like that.
Right.
It feels like forever.
And so you birthed through the water.
But yeah, I got here at like 9 o'clock and I had the baby by 12:45.
Mm-hmm. And you were home by?
I was home by, I don't remember.
4 o'clock.
4 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She wanted to walk home because she does live across the street.
I did. Or I didn't walk home, but I did want to.
Yeah. And we were like, well, maybe you should drive home. And she was like, well, the parking lot is just as far from where I park my car to walking to my apartment. It's just as far as me walking from here
It is.
Yeah. It just made us feel better for her to drive. And it was cold.
It was really cold. We ended up deciding not to because...
What month was it?
Mostly because it was cold.
Yeah.
December.
It was too cold. And it was really uneventful. It was very uneventful. And I think partly is because you got to that place where you just were like, all right, well, it's going to be what it's going to be.
Right. Yeah.
Really important.
Yep.
Really important.
It was great.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do it again.
Anything you would give future moms? Any advice? Having done it both ways, hospital,
right,
birth center.
Well,
epidural, no
my
epidural.
First advice is get a midwife. But no, but a lot of people have great hospital births as well. I just wasn't one of them.
Yeah.
But my biggest advice is probably just, go with the flow.
Did you feel like you went with the flow the first time in terms of your prenatal care? Were you calm and as joyful? Or did you have more anxiety?
No, I was fine. It was when I was actually, like, I went into the hospital going, like, you know what? I don't know if I want an epidural or not. This is my first baby. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hack it or not. I'm open to anything.
Great.
When the nurse was, like, giving me a really hard time, then I got really, like, I'm not getting an epidural, I got all belligerent about it.
Yeah, yeah.
But
that usually doesn't work so well.
No, no. So, hey, you.
I think she's close to
being good. This sure isn't breastfeeding friendly, I'm sorry. You're going to have to wait a second.
And she always has the most adorable clothes on because mom has a beautiful aesthetic. She's from Canada. That little bonnet. She wore this perfect, that you made?
No, I didn't make it.
Oh,
I didn't make it.
Perfect little bonnet.
But it's like Little House on the Prairie.
Oh, she has a couple bonnet home, and oh, it's just darling.
Oh, no, I did make that bonnet.
That little bonnet.
The crochet knitted one.
Knitted.
Yeah,
beautiful. Just sweet little bonnet that she put her in and put her in her car seat and drove her home. And so there you go. There's another great birth story. And I think really the recurring theme that we're always trying to drive home is birth is normal. Go with the flow. Try not to have any hard and fast rules about how you really want this thing to go. And it's so important to get to that place emotionally where you can let go and trust the process of birth. Know that you did your homework. Know that you have your team in place.
And then even if nothing happens, like in my case, you need to be at peace with it in order to relax and let your body do what it's going to do.
You
need to not have anxieties thinking about it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you so much for sharing your story. It's really awesome.
All right.
It's really important for women to hear positive birth stories.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We hear lots of scary birth stories. We feel like it's okay to share our really scary birth stories. And we've even had some women be told, maybe you shouldn't share your story because, it might make other women maybe not feel so good about their own birth. And keep those good stories to yourself because not everybody has that experience.
Mm.
But we need to share these good stories because we need women to know that birth is normal.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be beautiful. It can be really, it can be joyful, and it's awesome if it's joyful. It doesn't have to be joyful. So if you don't have a joyful experience, it doesn't mean you did it wrong.
Right,
some
right.
Some women, like, fight and scream. You guys have probably heard my birth story. I
My first don't was not joyful.
Yeah. I don't tend to birth very joyfully. I mean, I have a hard time when I have my babies, but you don't
I've
have to be joyful.
That,
but you have to be willing to go for the ride and be okay with the outcome.
Yeah.
So it's important to tell your story.
Okay.
So thanks for sharing with us.
Thank you.
Okay. If anybody wants more information, you can always contact at our website, scvbirthcenter.com. We have a great frequently asked questions page. We have a contact us page if you have any questions. Check out our events page, our resources page. We make referrals. You don't have to live in this area. You can call us. We'll make referrals to whatever area that you're in. We support midwifery care. We support hospital births. We're happy to make recommendations for good doctors and good midwives. We're not attached to where you have your baby. We are attached to you being informed and making good, informed decisions. It's not about where you birth your baby or how you birth your baby. So there you go. Thanks for listening, and feel free to email us with any questions.